We've all made our way to the city of sin. Now comes the time for the real fun to begin. So Leprechaun 3 tells the story of our little green demented monster chasing his one missing gold shilling across the casinos of Las Vegas. Welcome back to the Leprechaun Review Series, everybody. I've already reviewed the first two films, so if you missed those, be sure to hit the subscribe button and go check those out, and then come back and watch this one. Leprechaun 3 is a movie that I remember liking probably the most of this franchise as a kid. I remember going to Family Video, already told the story in two, checking out these movies, returning, getting the next sequel, going back and getting the next one. And Leprechaun 3, of all of the sequels, always stuck in my head the most. I don't remember if it was because it was the most gory, or if it because it was the most fun, or the most one-liners. I honestly did not remember walking into this what was so memorable about Leprechaun 3. And in the comments section of my first two reviews, it seems like a lot of you held this movie in high regard in this franchise as well. This one might be the fan favorite of this franchise. So I was excited to pop it in, watched it, revisited all the nostalgia of Leprechaun 3, and now I'm here to tell you what's good, what's bad, what's ugly about the third one. First and foremost, I think the Vegas setting in this movie is a lot of fun. It's always good when you can kind of change the aesthetic in a slasher film. They tried their best to do it in movies like Jason Takes Manhattan to mixed results. I think this one actually fares pretty well. We've gotten used to the farmland and the countryside and everything in the first couple, a little bit of city in there, but this one being the big city of lights, the city of sin, going into casinos, going into pawn shops, walking the strip, it's actually pretty fun. It adds a nice little flavor to the tone that they're going for in this movie. It adds to the fun factor, and it makes it a little bit more bright, a little bit more memorable, if nothing else, just for the setting. Something that improved in this movie that I've kind of harped on a little bit in the last two is that the kills are actually decent. Again, nothing that's like earth-shattering. There's no like top 10, top 20 kills of all time in Leprechaun 3, but they do have a bit more creativity. They do seem to focus more on the kills in a more traditional slasher sense. Those are kind of your money shots. That's what you're building to in Leprechaun 3. And it does have a little bit more gore, a little bit more carnage. Again, nothing earth-shattering. We're not painting the town red, but you do get somebody sawed in half with a chainsaw. And they even amp up some of the comedy regarding the kills too. It's not really going for the grossest kills. It's more so going for the goofiness. It plays along with the leprechaun's wit and some of that tone they've gone for in this franchise where you kind of mix horror and comedy. And it's going for that here. I mean, you have a kill where Caroline Williams, Stretch from Texas Chainsaw 2, is blown the fuck up because her tits, her ass, and her lips are enlarged to enormous amounts. You even have like the boss of the casino, the mob boss, kind of a dick, and he is electrocuted to death by a robot that he is convinced he is about to fuck. If you're gonna go for memorable, you got it. And even going to Warwick Davis. Now, he's pretty consistent throughout this whole franchise with his performance. You know, there's varying degrees of quality in the movies, but he's always pretty solid. His humor, his rhyming, is basically cranked up to 11 in this.
Oh, well, didn't you hear? Bigger is good, but jumbo is dear. I'll give you boobs that come out to here.
I think there might be two or three lines that he has in this movie that don't rhyme. When you have a sequel like this that's definitely trying to crank up the fun, trying to crank up the cheese, just trying to own what it is and be the best, worst possible version of itself, I think that that rhyming, that leprechaun wit, that cheesy dialogue of his, it's necessary to crank it up that way, and it does make this movie a lot more fun for his character than the previous two. Now moving on to the mixed, this movie is the definition of so bad that it's good. On its surface, it is terrible. The acting is atrocious. The characters are thin and one note and caricatures. The effects, the stage presence, the production value, all the way from the top to the bottom, is absolute trash. Some CGI effects in here with some of the leprechaun stuff going on, which has never been good. Even some of the gore effects. I mean, it's better than they have been with, you know, the guy getting pushed in half, but overall, everything about this movie on paper should be a failure. But for some reason, some movies can cross that line into being just such a train wreck that you enjoy it for the fact that it's a train wreck, And Leprechaun 3 is absolutely that movie thus far in the franchise. Something about watching these characters and the lines and the delivery coming out of their mouths and just the absolute lack of acting ability whatsoever just makes you smile. I mean, the guy gets his fucking arm bit, and then the very next scene, he's totally calm. He's like, yeah, I need to tell you about this leprechaun in your hotel. Yeah, the little green man. Well, he tried to kill me! In fact, I'll go out on a limb and say that this is probably the second most fun guilty pleasure leprechaun movie in existence.
Kyle, what are you doing? I don't know, I can't help it.
Don't judge me. Even to the point where, as a 90s kid, like the tone of the movie and the production value, even the music, it gave me like this goosebumps, Are You Afraid of the Dark vibe the entire time. Obviously, there's much more mature elements to this movie than anything you'd ever see in those shows, but I'm telling you, it's almost like they just borrowed a set and the leftover money from one of those episodes and just said, all right, we'll make a leprechaun movie with whatever's left. It feels identical to that stuff. And now moving on to the negatives, and before I start getting into specifics with this movie, I will say that I was not necessarily corrected, but maybe enlightened on something that I had an issue with in Leprechaun 2 and would have had an issue with in this movie and probably the following films. Apparently this is a different leprechaun every single movie. It's not meant to be this string of continuity, one character that gets killed and revived and killed and revived. I guess we're just getting different leprechauns, totally different stories, totally different universes in every movie. I don't know how I like that. I mean, this is a type of franchise where, fuck it, whatever, who cares about continuity, right? But at the same time, it seems almost like a really cheap excuse to not put any effort into stringing these movies together. So, whatever. If you're somebody that saw my gripe in the second film and said, hey, wait a minute, you don't... Okay, I acknowledge it. Different leprechauns. This one is revived by pulling a medallion off of a stone. Cool! One thing that kind of drug down the pace of the movie a bit for me, which is something that you don't really want to happen in a movie that's going for real guilty pleasure fun, is that there was too much back and forth with the same settings. Like, there was four or five different exchanges where the leprechaun went from the pawn shop to the casino, to the pawn shop to the casino, back to the pawn shop, back to the casino. And to the point where you as a viewer are watching this, I mean, there's even scenes where like they get into a limo and they're driving to stop the leprechaun. And I'm like, wasn't that shit just across the street? Because we've been there like eight times. And finally, I thought that the death of Leprechaun was pretty lame in this one. You get the first one, you get the four-leaf clover shoved down his gullet. That one was pretty cool. The second one, okay, he's allergic to iron. They shoved the little spear through him. Okay, fine. This one, we're just gonna blowtorch his pot of gold. No. Maybe if they had executed the scene better, I could get beyond that, but it's literally a guy, he just goes, screw your sharing, little guy, and like starts blowtorching this pot of gold, and then Warwick Davis is behind the fire, like contorting, and then the pot of gold just disappears. Doesn't explode, doesn't melt, just disappears, old 90s effect. And then it cuts immediately to Warwick Davis flying in midair on fire. Like, there's no scene that leads up to that. There's no like him jumping or him getting exploded and flying. No, he's just suddenly midair floating around until he's dead. That's fucking stupid. But overall, guys, guilty pleasures can be a lot of pleasure sometime. And Leprechaun 3, I understand why as a kid that didn't have a whole lot of taste at the time could watch this and just have an absolute blast with it. I can't say that I have the same amount of fun with it as an adult, but I can still appreciate this one. If I'm gonna watch a Leprechaun movie and I've already seen the first one recently, or I just wanna pick a sequel randomly, this so far is the one that I would go to just for the dumb fun of it. There is some decent kills. There's a little bit more fun, a little bit more rhyming, a little bit more playing into Warwick Davis's performance, but overall, still a cheap B-movie slasher. So know who you are. If you like the movies, if you like it so far, you should like this one a little bit more. If you hate the other ones, this ain't gonna change your mind. So if you like the Leprechaun films and you wanna have some fun in Vegas, this one has definitely got some fun in store for you. Don't expect a whole lot of quality, but do expect a lot of fun at the lack of quality. So check this thing out online and stream it. So what do you guys think of Leprechaun 3? Are you a fan of this one? Is this one your favorite, your least favorite? Did you grow up loving it? Is it something that you despise as an adult but loved as a kid? What are your thoughts? Let me know down below in the comment section, and we will talk about Leprechaun 3. And are you looking forward to the review for Leprechaun 4? What's in store for me with that one? Let me know, guys. Please like and share this video. Hit that subscribe button if you have not already hit the subscribe button so you can check out all the rest of the reviews in the Leprechaun franchise. Thank you guys for watching as always, and remember, opinions are like assholes, but that doesn't mean that you have to be.